Hi, welcome to Bearded Meeple. Now there's a saying, folks, you can't have one without the other, and in today's game, it definitely holds true. Don't get me wrong, I absolutely loved Raiders of the North Sea. I thought it was a fantastic game, great designer, brought to us by a great company, but with today's expansion, Fields of Fame, now I love it even more. Let's take a look at it. In the expansion, we have a new section of board that will attach to the main board, as well as components for a fifth player. We have cardboard chits to indicate multiples of coins and provisions, as well as additional workers. There are two new dice that you can use instead of the red dice that came with the base game. Then there's the blood chits. These will act as wounds on your crew, and even though they can be injured, they won't die from their wounds. We have new townsfolk that will be added to the main deck, and then there's the main thrust of the expansion, the Jarls. They're indicated by the turquoise shields, and their cards will greatly affect the game. Let's take a look at how it's going to set up and affect gameplay. Each player receives an encounter board in which they will be reminded how to interact with the Jarls and track what they do. You have your two coins, your worker, and your ship. Your first crewmate you'll hire for free. The other four cards are held in hand. The game suggests a new drafting method for selecting your cards, which I recommend, and all new cards have a white shield to indicate they're from the expansion. The new board is placed alongside the main board, and each player will place one of their scoring tokens to track their fame. Setup is initially the same, except in the bag, before pulling tokens, you will also add the turquoise Jarl tokens. You'll shuffle the Jarl deck, they also have a place for their discard, and we're ready to begin. Gameplay proceeds as normal. You're placing your worker and taking an action, and then retrieving a worker to take an action, or you're going to be plundering locations. With this expansion, you'll be interacting with the Jarls, either killing, subduing, or fleeing. We'll take a look at that in a moment. Another aspect of the game that's been added on is as you're attacking certain locations, you needed a certain amount of strength, resources, and crew. And if you hit a certain value, well, you'd gain so many points. If you had excess, it didn't really help you at all until now, because by having an excess amount of a certain number of strength, you'll receive so much fame and additional points at the end of the game. During gameplay, when you go to a location, remember you need to satisfy the requirements. A Jarl encounter will take place before a Valkyrie token is activated. You take the Jarl and you will place it on how you will react to it. If there's more than one, you can never flee and then interact with the others. You must kill or subdue, and then you could possibly flee if there were more. Depending on the number of tokens, you'll reveal a set amount of Jarl cards, and then you will choose what to do. If you decide to kill the Jarl, its strength is based on its card value plus one. Your crew will take that many wounds, and in future raids, wounds will decrease that crew member's strength. If you're successful in taking the wounds and defeating the card, you will gain two fame. If you decide to subdue the Jarl and add them to your crew, you take wounds based on the value minus one, so I would only take five injuries, but I also pay the cost based on the card, and now that person is added to my crew. Or you can simply flee, discard the card, and you will lose a fame, or you will lose points. And that, my friends, is Fields of Fame for Raiders of the North Sea. Now, a couple of things I would like to say, even though it may seem like a tiny expansion, It adds a lot of oomph to the game. And having said that, I'm also glad they added a fifth player so you can spread some of that love around. Now with this, your fight or flight instinct may kick in, because either you're going to fight all the Jarls, or try to subdue them and add them to your crew. Better yet, sometimes it's just safe to run away. I also like the fact that there's another way to get points in the game, so you can spread your focus around on how you're going to defeat your opponents. I really enjoyed it, but the thing is, it gets even better because there's a second expansion, Hall of Heroes. We'll take a look at it at another time. I absolutely loved it. I hope you get a chance to check it out. I'll talk to you again soon.